Okay, I think I've got it. I'm not sure. This is attempt number gazillion. This is Karl F. Rose recording live from Bedford, Pennsylvania on Friday, May 12th, 2017. And I'm trying to figure out my OBS and webcam. What OBS stands for is Open Broadcast System. So I was the funny thing is I was doing this live on YouTube. I thought I had it set to private, but actually it turned out to be public. I did have one person watching. They were watching me fumble and bumble and stumble. And I think I've got it. I'm not sure yet, but it looks like I have what I've been wanting to for a long time with this little thumbnail of me, and then the background of what it is that I'm going to talk about here. I'm just going to do a simple text edit. How I do my text edit with onto kind of like a plate with GIMP. And how what I'm doing is I copy and paste a kind of a Star Wars type non-moving two-dimensional, just a it looks like a kind of a Star Wars type text, and then I paste it onto one of my images. So okay, I've been spending a lot of time on this, so let me go into GIMP and let me see how this works. And we're just going to do something real simple here. So let me go into my GIMP and see. Okay, I set my I go into new, and then I set it to 3000. I'm going to do it the quick way. Width at 3000 and height at 800. Okay, and that's just mainly just because it conforms more with my pictures. I'm going to talk about a bunch of things. I'm going to talk about text. I'm going to talk about opacity. I'm going to talk about bucket fill. I'm going to talk about layers. I'm going to talk about merge and transformation. So let's get going on it. First of all, let's just pick the text. I'm going to go with something bold again. Let's just go with that. And I usually have it at about 130. Oops, wow. 130. And yeah, let me just get this here. Oops, 130. Okay, 130. I usually have a paragraph, so I'm just going to do something a little bit longer. Okay. How I add the XT and the ABANER STYLE graphic ABHIC TYPE image GE and paste PASTE onto one of my photos. Okay, all right, let's see. Okay, as you can see, okay, there we go. This is more like it. I try and center my text around the box here as closely as possible. Okay, we got that there. Okay, let's go. Click on the move. Let me go and make sure that this is working. Okay, good. Okay. Okay, go back into GIMP. Okay. Let's go into filters. Go to alpha and a logo. And oh, let's just give it an alien glow and see what we got here. Okay, we're just going to do that. And as you can see, you've got four layers here. Okay, there we go. and with the four layers, and what I do with this is I go is I merge the visible layers, then I go flatten. Okay, now, yeah, as you can see, it reduced it a little bit. It's not the 3,000 by 800, but it's still close enough. It's 2583 by 717. That'll work. Okay, now I'll right-click on this. I'm going to click Copy. Now I'm going to open. I'm just going to open a, let's go into Pictures. Let's just open up a project I'm working on, 3D evil monkey head, something I'm working on in Blender. Okay, then we go into Edit, we click Paste. Okay, we're going to get rid of this. It's going to tell me discard. Yeah, discard changes. I'm not keeping this, but I just like to. Now let's go to the Transform tool, and this is how I get all my angles and stuff. Okay, and then I just do this. This is just a very simplified version. I usually do a lot of other things, add drop shadows and things, and I'm going to do a bucket fill on this, but because I wanted to show you something. Okay, and as you can see there, I can reduce the opacity. There we go. You got the text, and then you can see the monkey. I'm gonna change the transformation a little bit more, just to kind of cover up the whole. Okay, then hit transform. Okay, and we're gonna merge it. Then I'm gonna add a. Then I'm just gonna do a quick bucket fill of one of my images here. Okay, there we go. I kind of like that, and I'm not keeping it. This is just, okay. And let's go to merge. We merge both of these layers together. Merge. Okay. Now we go to flatten. Flatten. It's kind of cool, actually. You got this going there. So now let's go to color select here. We're just going to select all this up here. And then this bucket fill. Go into bucket fill, and I'm just going to pick one of my patterns. I'll just go with one of my photo creations here. Let's see, what do we got? Textures, okay, we got, where are we at here? Oh, let's just go with a Christmas. Okay, there we are. Just gave it a Christmassy background there. Just go up here. Flatten image, and there you go. Got my monkey head with the text on there, and then I got the Christmas tree in the background. And but anyway, this is what I do. This is what I spend a lot of time doing, just different types of text, and I'm superimposing it over some of my images. I do my own textures and my own images and that sort of thing. Because otherwise you're going to end up with a possible copyright violation. I do go to textures.com, and those are you can use textures for free on there. You have to register, but that's a safe way to do it. If you go to if you try and copy and paste something from Google, an image, and put it on there, you're run the risk of copyright violation. Don't do it. You're stealing from other photographers and stuff. So go to texture.com if you don't have your own, but I like working with my own. Anyway, well, that's it. I will see you on the next video. I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to do now. Yeah, I combined two on there. Okay, we're going to stop the recording, and I think I got it. Were we recording? No, we. Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're recording. Okay. I was getting.